Hello, happy morning to all our loving students there. How are you students? I hope you are taking care of your health, right? And students, please keep updating your notebooks and don't forget to send me the photoshoots. So students, we are on chapter number 11, that is percentage. We have already covered till our part 5. This video is our part 6. In this video, we will learn how to calculate interest, so I can say computing simple interest. So students, in previous exercise, that is in exercise number 4, we learned that amount equals to principal plus interest. Remember, and interest equals to amount minus principal. So what is interest? Aaj hum is video mein ye sikhenge ki how to calculate interest. Okay?
Example 1. Rama borrowed rupees 5,000 from the money lender at 10% per annum. How much interest will Rama pay if he returns the money after 2 years? Solution: the money.
So students, first of all, we will read the question and we will identify that what is given in the question. Rama borrowed rupees 5,000 from the money lender at 10% per annum. So first of all, the principal amount will be 5,000. Rate of interest will be 10%. How much interest will Radha pay if she returns the money after 2 years? We are supposed to calculate the interest in rupees. Hame 10% per annum rate of return diya gaya hai. Per annum means for 1 year, Radha has to pay 10% as the interest. And now the time period is 2 years. So my principal amount will be 5,000. Rate of return, that means R equals to 10%. And T, that will be 2 years.
Money borrowed, rupees 5,000. 10% rate per annum means Radha has to pay rupees 10 on every 100 borrowed after 1 year. Interest on rupees 5,000 for 1 year is equal to 10% of rupees 5,000. Interest on rupees 5,000 for 2 years is equal to 5,000 into 10 upon 100 into 2, which is...
So students, 10% rate per annum means Radha has to pay rupees 10 on every rupees 100 borrowed money. अगर वो 100 पे बोल करती है तो उसे कितना पे करना पड़ेगा 10 रुपीस. That's the simple. For example, wait a second. See, total मेरा amount है 100 पर 10% 10 रुपीस मुझे पे करना है as the interest. So but naturally 5,000 पे मेरा कितना amount आएगा? I will calculate that. See, cross multiplication. 5,000 into 10 upon 100. The same concept. Understood students? जब भी आपको percentage दिया गया हो, तो सबसे पहले आप क्या करेंगे? उसको 100 के सामने रखेंगे. अगर मैं 100 रुपीस लेती हूँ, तो मुझे 10 रुपीस as an interest पे करना पड़ेगा. Understood? तो जो भी आपको principal amount दिया है, वो 100 के नीचे आ जाएगा. So this will be the 0 0 cut, second 0 second 0 cut. So my answer will be 500. 500 एक साल का है, but दादा ने कितने time के लिए लिया है? 2 years के लिए. So that will be 1,000. Understood students?
Rupees 1,000. In short, simple interest is equal to P into.
So students, after understanding this sum, I come to one formula. That is, this formula is very important. Whenever it is asked to calculate the interest, you will apply this formula. P into R into T upon 100. P means principal, R equals to rate of interest, and T equals to time divided by 100. P into R into T divided by 100. Understood?
to R into T upon 100, P principal, R rate per annum, T time years. Here it is important to note that P and SR are in rupees. R is the rate of interest for a period of time, that is in the same unit as I. Example 2. Please follow the given.
So students, now it is example 2. Let's read it together. Find the amount payable and I need to calculate the amount payable to the bank on a loan of rupees. This will be my 5500 will be my P. At 15%, this will be my R. For 3 years, this will be my A, or I can say T for time. Simple, but actually amount ka formula kya hota hai? Principal interest. Mere paas principal already hai 5500. I need to calculate the interest. Interest is there, but it is in percentage form. I will convert that. Uske liye main formula use karungi. That is, simple interest equals to P into R into T divided by 100. This is the formula. See, P into R into T. P, that means principal amount, 5500. R equals to 15 into 3. 0, 0, 0, 0 cut. The remaining of multiply karoge, aapka aa jayega interest mein amount. So your, sorry, ye aapka aa jayega interest rupees mein. Now you will calculate the amount. For that, the formula will be amount equals to principal plus interest. Interest maine rupees mein calculate kar liya. So now 5500 plus 2475 equals to total. Understood students? Have a look properly. Jo maine previous sum mein se formula derive kiya tha simple interest ka, wahi maine yahan apply kiya. That's it. First of all, mujhe interest percentage mein diya tha, so I converted into rupees. So simple, right?
Steps to get the answer. Example 3. Mrs. Khanna made a deposit of rupees 20,000 in her bank for 3 years. The rate of interest is 7.5% per annum. Find the money Mrs. Khanna will get back after.
So students, again one example, we will be solving this. Mrs. Khanna made a deposit of 20,000. So ye mera ho jayega principal amount. In her bank for 3 years, so ye mera ho jayega time. For 3 years. The rate of interest is 7.5. So ye mera kya ho jayega rate of return. Find the money Mrs. Khanna will get after 3 years. Mujhe matlab find the money. So mujhe kya calculate karna hai? Amount. Amount ka formula kya hoga mera? Principal plus interest. Interest is given in percentage. I need to calculate in rupees. For that I will apply my simple interest formula. P into R into T divided by 100.
After 3 years, convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. Solution. Here, P, principal, is equal to 20,000 rupees. R, rate of interest is equal to.
Here I will convert this into mixed fraction. Understood students?
7.5%, which is equal to 15/2%. T time 3 years. SI is equal to P into R.
So, maine kya kiya? Simple maine usse formula mein place kar diya. P into R into T upon 100. 20,000 into 15/23 divided by 100. 0, 0 cut. 0, 0 cut.
Into T upon 100, which is equal to 20,000 into 15/2 into 3/100, which is equal to 20,000 into 15.
See students, what happened? Ye wala jo 2000 niche aa jayega. Always remember, जब ये भी इनप्रॉपर फ्रैक्शंस में होगा तो ये वाला 2 है ना वो यहां पर नीचे आ जाएगा 20000 into 15 into 3 upon 100 into 2 0 0 0 0 cut 2 1s are 2 hundreds are you can see the calculation now I will simply multiply and I will calculate my answer so students I hope this topic is clear right let's move to worksheet so students this is your exercise number 5 and this will play the role of worksheet but remember in this we will have a short worksheet you will be able to solve question number 1 question number 2 and question number 3 you can try question number 4 and question number 5 they are easy if you have any doubt you are free to contact your ma'am okay students take care of yourself bye students god bless you study well